Hello everyone, welcome back to Anonymous World. So in last video we saw Linux fundamentals part 1. So in this video we will so walk through of Linux fundamental part 2. So let's get into the video. Okay, so in last video we saw Linux fundamentals part 1. In this video we will do Linux fundamentals part 2. Okay, so first again in task 1 there is introduction. So in part 2 there will be no in browser functionality and you need to use the attack box, which is right given here, start attack box. If you are not a premium member, you can use it for 1 hour, or if you are premium then you can use it for as long as you want, and also you can use a virtual machine, it depends on you. So here I will be using attack box. Okay, so let's proceed. In Linux fundamental part 2 we will see some more commands. In part 1 we saw some commands like echo, who am I, and some operators like greater than, double greater than, which are used for appending or overlapping the contents of the file. Okay, so let's go to task 2. Task 2 is about accessing our Linux machine using SSH. SSH stands for secure shell. Okay, so we will be deploying two machines. First the Linux machine, which is here, start machine, and the attack box. Okay, so we will click on start machine. So as you will click on start machine, this bar will come where you will get your IP address, and then you start your attack box. Click on start attack box. Okay, so it's starting your machine. Till then let's see what's given in the theory part. So it's given the working of the SSH. You need to use the command SSH and then enter the username and the IP address. Username and IP address of the machine, and then enter the correct credentials to get access to the SSH server. Okay, so we deployed our machine. We clicked on the start attack box. So here is the syntax of using SSH. So SSH, then username, then machine IP. So in this case, our username is tryhackme, and also the password is tryhackme without the quotation. So let's wait for our attack box. Okay, so our attack box is loaded. Now we will log into SSH. Press enter to close this, then click on terminal. Okay, so the command for SSH, login to SSH is SSH, then username, which is tryhackme, IP address. So our IP is 10.10.138.1, 10.10.138.1. Click enter. Are you sure want to continue connecting? So yes. Then enter the password, which is also tryhackme. Okay, so now we are into our SSH. I have logged into Linux fundamental part 2 machine with SSH completed. Okay, so now let's move to third task, introduction to flags and switches. Also you can, if you want to use this machine in full size, then you can go here, view in full screen. It will open the machine in next tab. Can just maximize it. Can clear the terminal. You are ready to go. Okay, so in task 3, introduction to flags and switches. Okay, so there is a man command which stands for manual, by which you can see the use of any particular command. if the man page is available. For example, let's see man ls. So you can see it gives the manual page of ls command. Ls list directory contents, then description of ls, then all the switches and flags that are supported with ls are given here. Like capital A for almost all, small a for all, hyphen B for escape. So you can read it on your own. You can quit this manual page by pressing Q. Then there is one option, help, ls double hyphen help. This also gives you all the flags supported by a particular command. Just man command gives in a more detail. Okay, so let's see what, explore the manual page of the ls command. So we just did it. What direction arrow key would we use to navigate down the manual page? Of course, if you want to go down, then we will use the down arrow. Down. Okay, we can try it. Man ls. Yes, so down arrow navigates us to down. What flag would we use to display the output in a human readable way? So again, you need to search in help command or man ls. Let's see, help of ls. Now just you need to search which flag is used for human readable format. So you need to search a bit. So here it is, small hyphen h is for human readable. Okay, small hyphen h for human readable. Okay, so the next task is file system interaction continued. Why continued? And part one we saw the commands find and grep. Here we will see some another commands. So we will see about touch. Touch is used to create file. I told you that we can create files with using touch, and I told we will see next video. So here it is. Mkdir stand for make directory for creating a folder, cp for copy, mv for move, rm for remove, and file is used to check the type of a file, like it's an image data, video data, or something else, zip file or anything. Okay, so we will directly go to the task. We will clear the terminal. Okay, so how would you create the file named new node? So just we saw touch is the command used to create a new file. So touch new node. Now we will do ls. As you can see, new node is created. So the answer will be touch new node. Okay. Now next question. On the deployable machine, what is the file type of unknown one in PryHackMe's home directory? Okay. So here is a file named unknown one. By simple ls, we are not able to see anything else about the information of this particular file. So we will use ls hyphen al. So now you can see some extra information of a particular file in unknown one. You can see the user owner is tryhackme. Permissions are read write. Okay, so next question. On the deployable machine, what is the file type of unknown one in TryHackMe's home directory? Okay, so we will do ls. There is a file unknown one. Now how to see the file type? Just we saw we use command file, then the file name unknown one. Okay, unknown. Okay, sorry, spelling mistake. Unknown one. So the file type is ASCII text. So ASCII text. Okay, we got it right. Now how would we move the file, my file, to the directory my folder? Okay, we have here one file named my file and one folder named my folder. So we need to move my file to my folder. So for moving any file or folder, the command is mv. So we will use mv. What we are moving? We are moving my file. Then where we are moving? My folder. Then mv command, then source file, then the destination, source file name, then the destination. Now we will do ls. Now you can see my file has just gone from here. Now if you go inside my folder, you can find the my file there. So we will use cd my folder. Now here you can see my file has is there. Okay, so answer will be mv my file my folder. Now what are the contents of this file? So how to read content of the file? Using cat command, cat my file, thm file system. So we got our flag thm file system. Okay, next, continue to apply your knowledge and practice the command from this task. Okay, so you do it on your own. Some try creating some new files, moving it here and there, and just play around it. Okay, so now moving to task 5, which is permission 101. Okay, so it tells about permissions of a particular file or folder or anything. Okay, I will show you directly using commands. Let's clear this. We will move back to our try-acmis directory. Now with the simple ls command, we just see the contents in a particular directory. But if we use ls hyphen al, we can see some more information, right? Like the time of creation, last edited, who is the owner of a particular file, and what is this drwxr hyphen xr which is written. Okay, so let's see of a new note. The hyphen says, hyphen means it is a file. If there is a written d, then it means it's directory. But I will say it in full screen. Okay, so d stands for directory and a simple hyphen stands for a file. Then r stands for read, w stands for write, and x stands for execute. First rwx is for owner, then second rwx, so here there is no w, it means it has permission only of read and execute. Second is for groups, and last r hyphen x is for any guest user. So guest user has also permission of read and execute only. Okay, so first question is, who on the deployable machine, who is the owner of important? So important, here is important, and the owner is user 2. We can see there will be user 2. Now what will the command to switch to user 2? Okay, so now in one system there can be one more than one user, more than one group. So how to switch between them? So for switching between users, we use command su. Su is used for switching between different users. Su, then the user to which we want to switch, and then the password. Okay, so what will the command to switch to user 2? So it will be su user 2. Okay, now switch to user 2 using the password user 2. So how we will switch? Su. First I will show you who am I. We get the answer try hack me. Now we will switch to user 2. Su user 2, it's asking a password, so password is also user 2. So now if I do who am I, you can see now I am in user 2 login. Okay, so now output the contents of important. What is the flag? So now we will read the important by using cat important thm su user 2. So we get our flag. Okay, so now let's move to task 6, which is common directories. So there are four common directories given. First one is etc folder. etc stand for etc. You must know this. So this is a common location to store system files such as password files, shadow files, and sudoers files, etc. etc. You can see it in a screenshot. There are way lot more than files in etc folder. Then second is var file. Var file is one of the root folders found in Linux. This stores data written by services or applications such as log files, databases. Then there is root folder. Root folder is basically for root user. Suppose here is home tryhackme. So tryhackme is for tryhackme user. Then user two folder will be for user two owner. Similarly, root is for root owner. Then at the last is TMP folder, which stand for temporary. It is used for storing for once or twice. As you will restart your machine, all the data stored in TMP directory will be vanished. So basically like RAM, which stores for one time. Okay, so readme done. What is the directory path that would we expect logs? So we just saw logs are in var directory, var logs submit. You can find it here. Clear. Can see cd var ls. Here is cd log. Cd log. And inside log, you can see many files. You can see many files are there in cd log. Okay, next question. What root directory is similar to how RAM on a computer works? So we just saw TMP directory is similar to RAM. All the data gets away as we restart. Name the home directory of root user. We just saw root is root directory, root folder is for root owner. So root. Now apply your learning and navigate through these directories on the deployed Linux machine. So you do it on your own and explore different directories, etc, TMP, var logs. Okay, then task 7, conclusion and summaries. So concluding, in this part we learned how to connect through SSH, advanced command using flags, man command, then file interaction command like copying, moving, making directories, introduction to file permissions and switching between two users, and some common directories of a Linux system. Okay, so that's it for this video. I will see you in next video with Linux Fundamental Part 3. Till then, keep learning.
Bye.